Welcome to this video. Today we are going to talk about the basic movements, the most easy and consistent movement to the four corners around the full court. So the first thing we're going to go through is what's going on in the center position of the court. Before we go to all the four corners, we need to have focus on the technique, on the split step and how we move away from the center position. It all starts with the split step, and it starts with a directional split step. So if I want to go to my forehand corner at the net, my split step would go like this. So I'm in a better position of moving quickly this way up to my forehand corner. That's really important. When we have to move away from the center position, it's important that you don't land with both of your feet at the same time on the floor. In this case, to the front court, the forehand, you land on your back leg just a little bit before you land on your front leg. So when playing badminton, we have a lot of change of direction. We have so many jumps and lunges, and our ankles and our Achilles are really exposed of injuries. And to support all that, I use the Protec sock from Lightguard. It gives me a really good feeling on court and it's really comfortable. First corner that we're gonna take a look at is the front court, forehand side. We start with the directional split step, like this. We have, as you can see already now, the side to the net. After the directional split step, a side shuffle comes in, and then the lunge. When we have to go back from the corner, all the way back to the center position, we need to push off with our lunge leg using like the trampoline movement. So when you land, you push back at the same time, take a step, and then you are back at the split step. Next corner we have to focus on is the front court backhand side. So we have a directional split step, again like this, and then comes just one big lunge all the way to the corner. If you have some trouble reaching all the way from the center position to the corner, we can add an extra small jump with our left leg just after the split step. So we do the split step like this, and then we make a small jump, and then we launch. Once again, when I'm landing after my lunge, we have to move away from the corner back to the center position. It's the same as in the forehand side. We use the lunge's power to bounce back, make a step, and then you're back with the split step. Next corner is at the baseline in my forehand side. So we start off with the directional split step like this. Again, pointing towards the corner we want to go to. After the split step comes a side shuffle. After the side shuffle comes our scissor jump, like this. And when we land our scissor jump, it's important that our back leg lands down so we're able to push away from the corner. After we land and push away, we actually just walk towards the middle again, like this, and then we're ready to go to a new corner. Last corner is our baseline backhand side. We start up in our center position with our directional split step, like this, ready to go that way. After the split step, we have a rotation in our body, and at the same time, a small jump with our back leg. So that looks like this. After this jump and this rotation, we do our scissor jump. Like in the forehand side, we land down in our legs, and then we push away with our back leg towards the center again. On the two baseline corners, you can, if you want to reach further, you can add an extra side shuffle to your movement to be able to move all the way to the baseline. If you want to buy this ProTech sock from Lightguard, you can hit the link in our description and you will get a 10% discount using the Badminton Family discount code. Thanks a lot, guys, for watching this video. We really appreciate it. If you have any comments or any questions at all, you can just leave a comment below. We will look them through and give you a reply as soon as possible.